Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Welcome back to game number two here between NewBee.Miracle and DK in the VPGame Groupstage qualifiers. So let's head over to game two, see what we're handling here in the draft. You already had a sneak preview of what was going on, but I can also welcome in Scant, my co-caster today. Game number one, a lot one-sided, I've got to say. Does come down a little bit to the draft, but NewBee.Miracle now with a Wisp Tiny. What do you think about that?
Well, the Wisp Tiny combo is a combo that is extremely potent, and very rarely do we see it lose if the game goes the way that the Wisp Tiny team wants it to go. But it just makes me think that maybe DK go for another group up and push lineup. Sniper's not a bad start to that. Clockwork's pretty good against the Wisp and Tiny, and we have seen that before as well. I think you and I cast a week or two ago, or I can't remember. I think it might have been eHome versus NewBee, or HGT versus NewBee, something like that, where there was a Wisp Tiny combo that also got countered by this kind of group up and push strategy. Yes. Because the Wisp Tiny wants to get a certain amount of farm before it can start split pushing and just dominating fights. And if it doesn't get to that point, it can run into trouble against the group up lineup. Also, the sniper in the mid lane against the Wisp Tiny combo, assuming they're mid, sometimes with a little bit of help, the sniper can actually win that lane. I think we saw that in that same game. The sniper was making kills on the Wisp and not dying.
Yeah, that was NewBee against eHome. eHome had Sniper, Treant, Lifestealer, Tidehunter, and Shadow Shaman, while NewBee had the Tiny Wisp, Lion, Slark, and Clockwork. It definitely didn't go NewBee's way, but obviously we've got a couple of different teams here. DK, if they've been following the top-tier Chinese Dota teams, which I'm pretty damn sure they have, they'll know what to do to deal with this. I'm kind of wondering, actually, if they go with a very similar draft to what eHome going. They've already got the Sniper. Clockwork is a little bit different, but still with that long-range initiation, similar role as the Tidehunter. They just need a little more push. Shadow Shaman's still available. Treant, I'm not sure if they need to go for that, but it's always good to have a Treant against the Tiny Wisp, you know? Living armor across the map when you get relocated on.
The Treant's not for the push per se, but the Treant's for, like, Sniper's going to actually win the lane if he has tree armor. I think he's going to win the lane against Wisp and Tiny. So it might be a worthwhile pick on that basis. But yeah, you're right. They'd want one or two more heroes for pushing if that's their plan. Like maybe the Shadow Shaman and then one other core that can frontline. Possibly the Lifestealer, which we've seen as being so successful in these group up strategies.
Yeah, he jumps in, he fights. He's got that built-in BKB with Rage. But you know, he could even work with the Clockwork. Jump into the clock, hook shot in. You've got that bomb just to try and pick someone off. Tiny Wisp, they need some space and time. They need a good 15 to 20 minutes, depending on, you know, how well or how badly laning phase goes, to get that Aghanim's up. We've even seen players like Ferrari, when he's been playing Tiny, if the laning phase goes that badly, he feels the need to go for a Blink Dagger first. It does give you a lot more killing opportunity, but it's mainly the jumping between camps to farm more efficiently, and then the ability to jump in or out of team fights and that initiation from the opponent.
Alright, so the Tidehunter banned by Super, and then the pickup of the AA. So it might be going a slightly different direction to what I expected. The AA is really good against the Wisp conventionally as well, because it stops the Wisp from healing anyone up. Also just good in the lane stage. So actually, weirdly enough, I haven't seen this before, but have you seen Chilling Touch with Sniper? That should be pretty good. Maybe not early on, but later on with that super long range and high attack speed with Chilling Touch, that could be a pretty cool little combo.
Oh yeah, Mask of Madness, Sniper with Sound and Yasha, Chilling Touch, just right-clicking away. And Sniper's not such a bad hero against Wisp. As long as he can get his positioning right, as long as Wisp Tiny relocating somewhere that, you know, Sniper can maybe blink away from if he goes for that. We haven't seen it in a long time, and I'm just bringing this up because he's against Tiny Wisp. The old Mask of Madness blink that we saw on Drown Sniper, it's still, you know, viable just to give you that that escape mechanism. Just jump back if you see the relocate coming in. But more likely, he'll go for the movement speed build and just run himself around the little pitter-patter of his tiny feet. Sniper is the little man with the big nose.
But if the clock's covering him and Wisp and Tiny relocates onto him, he sets up his shrapnel, walks a bit to the side, clock hooks in, cogs them. That looks pretty good for the clock sniper combo.
Yeah.
Which is fairly doable. But I imagine if Wisp and Tiny relocate for ganks, they'll have a setup with them, and then that changes things around.
Well, what do we have currently not picked here? Shadow Fiend is still available, but DK with a sniper that did you put him mid against Tiny Wisp?
I mean, I really think that Sniper does well in that lane if he has, like, a little bit of help. Yeah. So the question is if they think they can give him that little bit of help. I'm not sure. There's ways to switch your lanes around. You can even put the clockwork mid there if you really want to. I don't know if you saw, there was a big match earlier this week where Alliance beats Team Secret, and a lot of people have been talking about. And game two of that series involved Alliance running the Wisp Tiny mid against RTZ Shadow Fiend, and the Shadow Fiend got totally, totally destroyed. He had about 5 creeps in 15 minutes. So some, I mean, that's maybe exaggerated, but at level 4, the Shadow Fiend went to, like, gang the off lane because he couldn't do anything in his lane.
Oh, really?
So like, a well-played Wisp and Tiny in mid lane, and Aki's been playing that Wisp really well recently, but a well-played Wisp and Tiny in mid lane really does dominate almost anything. But my experience is that Sniper with a Shrapnel, which is, like, the most ridiculous spell in the game at the moment, Sniper with a Shrapnel and a little bit of help from someone is one of the better ways to deal with it.
We'll see how things go. Right now, it looks like DK are heading towards a Zeus support with AA in that 5 role. They've got the global power there of Ice Blast and Thunder God's Wrath. Finish things off with an Assassinate. They've got so much, you know, sort of long-range artillery. They've got Hookshot, they've got the Ice Blast, they've got so many things just to throw at this tiny Wisp, regardless of where they are on the map. So they're countering the global relocate with global damage and global team fight. So NewBee.Miracle going for the Viper there to try and hold down their lanes and help with you know, pushing in and controlling these team fights. But what are we looking as the fifth ban here? Kind of expecting an offlane hero. Yeah, there's the Phoenix banned out. They don't have any silences, not too many stuns to actually lock him down. So Phoenix would be a pretty difficult hero to deal with. I feel that's a good ban. While NewBee.Miracle, Clockwork offlane you're dealing with, it should be fine for the Viper to handle that. Earthjager can move between lanes, maybe stay up with the Viper to find kills onto clock. It's pretty good up against the cogs if you block him in. So now you're looking for an offlane hero that can deal with Zeus AA plus one. But you want to try and ban out a plus one that can combo up with AA Cold Feet? Something that does well with Chilling Touch as well. So you're kind of looking at ranged heroes with a stun possibly.
I mean, Zeus and AA both have insane harass ability to zone you out at the start, so it's quite scary trying to think of a hero that's like not just going to be chased out of the lane. And I wonder if they maybe look for a hero that could dip into the jungle as a result.
Yeah, my first thought was Batrider, then I realized it's first banned here from DK.
The Axe is available, although last game didn't go so well for them.
Oh, man. Axe gets demolished by Chilling Touch.
Yeah, actually, he'd have to pretty much go straight to the jungle, I think.
So what's a hero? Oh, yeah, that's a really good shout, actually. We've seen that from NewBee and a couple of other teams. The Slardar AA with the Chilling Touch, the stun, Cold Feed, just combo things up. But DK, they already had something in mind. Pounce up and take people down.
Yeah, Sylar's been playing the Slardar quite a lot as well for LGD recently. But yeah, Slark, I like Slark here because you've got 4 heroes that can like support you from far away. Slark just goes deep, has his ulti to protect him, has his Dark Pack to protect him. So he just like goes deep behind enemy lines and tries to like run reconnaissance initially. You know, just like, okay guys, everyone aim your laser beams at this spot. And he can get out if he needs to. So I like the strategy, and okay, it's going to be an offlane pack by the looks of things.
Well, that's a hero
I think
that
is going to really struggle.
Yeah, it's a hero that can potentially survive, and you can probably hear in my tone of voice that I'm not too certain about this. But we'll see how things go. We'll see how things go. It could be actually a dual lane, you know, Earthshaker and Puck. And with that, once Puck hits level 2, 3, they could turn around and potentially fight up against the AA. Launch a Fissure, the level 2 Illusory Orb. A lot of damage to pump out. They just have to be very wary about the positioning of that Puck, because if he gets pounced on and doesn't have the orb to escape, that's Puck's death.
Yeah, and I wonder if we're going to see a completely explosive Slark this game the way we saw that completely explosive Troll last game. Because that's a hero that you really don't want to explode on you. It's possibly even scarier than the Troll with a good start, the Slark, the way it snowballs.
Oh, definitely. Definitely, when you've got supports that like to stand sort of in the depths of team fights and get behind your core heroes, Wisp, Earthshaker, having a Slark that could potentially just appear next to them and take them out before they get their abilities out is a very very scary prospect. A safe lane tiny Wisp.
This Slark, I was just watching him, he changed his starting item build like 3 or 4 times. And I'm not sure what it started on, but I saw him sell a bunch of items, and then he bought like 8 tangos, and then right before the time ran out, he was like, actually, I don't want 8 tangos, and he sold them and like changed back to self and one set of tangos.
That's kind of interesting. I'm not sure what they actually expect in terms of lanes here. Wisp is still going for that straight up bottle rush. Observer wards placed in exactly the same place. Radiant got theirs down first, though. So they know exactly where the Dire Observer is. They saw Earthshaker going up there, saw him placing it, and they'll probably go and deward that as quickly as they can. Cold Snap with Boots first. It will be offlane Puck.
What's the plan for Zeus? Support Zeus saving his gold? Is it like he might want sentry wards, or is this like a bottle rush so he can help out mid lane?
I'm not sure. It might be, you know, if I need sentry wards to deward camps, then I'll go for it. But... Super is not going mid, right? Super is going mid.
No.
He can't. He's just blocking.
He's just blocking for him, yeah.
Yeah.
And he's bought some items now, some tangos and some clarities, so... Just, you know, saving himself the chance of getting something different, I guess.
It could actually be that... The Zeus stays mid a little while or goes up to top and plays that sort of Sky Wrath kind of role. You know, throws out the chain lightning and harasses people down.
I think at level 1, that's the best role for support Zeus. Just like, use all your mana harassing someone. Afterwards, you find other things to do, but it does really well in that Sky Wrath role, as you call it. At the start, anyway.
Oh, I might have to reconnect. I'm getting the little spikes. I don't think I'm getting... Oh, I am getting uncompressed updates. Well, hopefully no one dies. I'm reconnecting. Fingers crossed.
They've paused the game.
Oh, they're lagging as well.
Yeah, Cold Snap, the pack is disconnected apparently. He's getting some lag too.
Okay, so it's not just me. Good timing. Right, I'm back in. And then Viper disconnects.
So I'm interested in actually the fact that they chose not to run Wisp and Tiny mid. Maybe sensing that the sniper with a little bit of help actually does reasonably well in that lane, just because of the power of shrapnel. So Viper goes mid instead, and Viper vs Sniper is a pretty close matchup, I think. I feel like it goes quite a lot down to like player skill execution.
Oh yeah.
Either hero could win this lane.
It comes. I think it's sort of like 20% player skill, but. 80% is like creep equilibrium, but obviously, you know, player skill actually goes into that. I think it's almost entirely down to controlling the creep wave. Because if the Viper can get it, you know, further back, sort of in this area where his creep wave is now, on top of his ramp, not just in front of it, then he can position himself in the river or on top of the enemy ramp and just, you know, force the sniper back. But if it stays where it is now, sniper has a massive upper hand. He's got headshot, he's got shrapnel, he can start harassing down the Viper. Level 1 Nether Toxin, sure, you're going to last hit a little bit better, but Viper's real lane dominance starts hitting at level 3 and 4. When you've got a couple of levels in Poison Attack, you've got a level in Corrosive Skin to deal with the shrapnel damage.
Yeah, and the bot lane pack's being zoned out solo by the Ancient Apparition at the moment, without the Zeus even being there. I wonder, the Zeus probably was planning on going mid to help against Wisp Tiny, and then he sees Wisp Tiny's top and he's like, fine, I'll go there. I think it's a bit better for him if they're mid, actually. It's easier for the Zeus to zone without stealing XP, whereas in this top lane, if he's going to harass you, he's definitely just sharing the lane with Clock. There isn't really a place he can stand to get the harassment without getting the XP.
I think another big thing with mid is that he can contest the rune. So he can see when the Wisp is moving across, he can go and zap him down, maybe steal the rune off him. Sure, Zeus isn't the quickest guy, 295, well, he's exactly the same movement speed as the Wisp, in fact. So both of them would be sort of waddling their way across to the rune spot to try and pick it up.
So that's definitely one advantage of, because the Wisp Tiny is safe lane and not mid, it ends up putting the Zeus in the position he doesn't want to be in. Because the Zeus definitely is more mobile and better at doing the harass without stealing XP thing in both the other lanes. Better at getting the runes, as you say. He'll probably end up just walking around controlling runes anyway. But then the information will definitely be available whenever he does go, and they'll be able to try and race him for it.
Yeah, well, so far we've got Super on the Zeus up on top lane, Black Zed playing the Clockwork off lane. Tiny, oh boy. NewBee Miracle, I've got to go back and look at their team roster. We can go across the other players and then the last one left. 5400 is a stand-in on the Wisp. Mid lane, we have AGK, an ex-for-love player, and what else was he? HGT? No. For Love and CNB. Like, Sun Tzu's been talking to me and saying this is basically the old For Love roster with XTT on it. Cold Snap down on bot lane with Earthshaker behind him. Who's left? Xiaobai and Yim. I'm not sure which one's which, though. So, one of them, the Tiny or the Earthshaker, is Xiaobai. One of them is Yim.
Alright. So, going back to the discussion of getting runes, I actually think if we look at the way the lanes are matching up, that top rune is going to, like, decide a lot of the lane stage, who gets it. Because Wisp and Tiny, kind of, like, you know, the Wisp with that bottle rush, he really wants to get that rune. Like, what does he do otherwise? Does he bottle crow, or...
Well, I guess you don't need to send the courier anywhere else. Viper doesn't really care too much about the... You know, until he has enough money for boots, and until he wants to start bringing out some bigger items to himself. Ring of Aqua boots, probably the biggest things for him. Bottle, not too popular on Viper, but maybe.
Yeah, because it's something people take for granted about the strength of a Wisp tiny lane. A lot of it has to do with the fact that Wisp always has a bottle, and it always has charges in it, and if that's not the case, it changes the dynamic quite substantially, I think. So, I wonder if Zeus will be able to contest the rune pickups. Maybe Clockwork helps, maybe Sniper helps. I mean, when there's a Sniper involved, if he sees there's going to be action at the rune, if he gets there with his shrapnel, that's usually going to go well for the Sniper's team.
Why is the Wisp invisible?
Is he invisible? Oh, yeah, that's weird.
He's actually...
He looks like a Dota 1 Phantom Assassin.
Oh, we had that bug last night, actually, with PA actually going invisible on our team. It started off with the Phantom Assassin sort of... You know when the movement animation glitches out and people just sort of slide around?
Yeah.
We had that for the PA. So she was, you know, skating around, practicing her ice skating. And then after a pause, she went invisible. So full on, you could not see her hero model or anything like that. Some interesting things happen sometimes in Dota 2. We didn't actually look at this. There's this bot lane. Virgo on the Slark. He's missed out on a last hit, in fact. Oh dear. Not the 100% perfect start that he got last game with the troll even.
Yeah, I don't know why he'd be missing last hits. I wonder, like, maybe he's thinking about going to help go on Pack, but that's... Yeah, maybe what happened is you can see Pack used an orb. So Packard's just orbed back to the position he's in. And possibly the Slark was heading forward to try and force him to do that. Missed a creep in the process.
Yeah. Alright, back into the game. Cog straight down onto the Tiny and draining his mana out a little bit. Sniper. And this middle lane does have the creeps where he wants them. And he's going to start right-clicking away at that Viper shortly.
The Sniper's sending himself a bunch of extra tangos. So he's planning to trade hits here.
Yeah, you definitely have to take into account that the poison attack from Viper is going to come thick and fast once he hits level 3. He's actually gone for corrosive skin at level 2. So he's going for the defensive build here on the Viper just to deal with that shrapnel. Sniper is, what, half a level ahead of him? Yeah, it's looking a little bit rough.
I like the adapting of the Sniper build. Yeah, usually you always see the level 2 shrapnel at level 3. But you want the early points and take aim in this lane, I think. Because otherwise, these kind of positions are going to favor the Viper far too much.
Wisp up at top, dropping down to half HP, but tethers across to that Tiny should be perfectly fine. Mid lane, this is where Viper kind of wants to be, but I don't know, the creep wave, where's it going to meet? Okay, this is good for the Viper now. It's going to be a little bit annoying with Sniper's extra range, just taking down these creeps, denying as much as he can, but with Nether Toxin, you should be fine.
Okay, top lane, Clockwork tried to actually go in on the Wisp here, but... Tether just getting the Wisp to safety.
Oh, Earthshaker. Earthshaker and Viper looking at the Sniper mid lane. Two-thirds of his HP remaining. 400 is the value right now. As they're looking for the Fissure into the slow and then taken down with a few more right clicks. Back in the Radiant Jungle though. Cold Snap. The Puck and the Yes, they've found Cheesery. AA has a Tango to jump through the trees with a Vortex. He'll slow them down as well. Level 1 Orb. And level 1 in Waning Rift.
If he orbs in, he's going to die.
Yeah. Oh,
Clark will kill him.
He's going. He's not jumping. He can't jump.
No, he doesn't jump. Yeah. Yeah, if he were to jump in there, there's no way he gets away from Slark.
Yeah, and you see now, once Viper hit that level 3, it's where he starts dominating this lane up against the Sniper. Black Zed up atop, looking for the damage down onto the Tiny while Zeus is dealing with the Wisp. Sniper losing a lot of his HP here, trying to trade hits as much as he can, but right now 14 for 6 on the Viper while Sniper's sitting at 6 for 3.
Yeah, that's the issue basically. Sniper wins lanes using Shrapnel, and Shrapnel's not very good against Viper because he's got the corrosive skin, because he can, you know, tank it a little bit, you take some damage.
Good Fisher down. They're going to find the kill onto AA first. Waiting Rift. No. No mana. He's got no mana. He does have one right click remaining though. There's the Slark in the back end. Looks for the kill onto the Earthshaker. Won't get it. The TP out will mean that there's no trade here from DK. A good, good fight for that dual lane down and bot. The Puck and ES making things work. As we look back to mid lane and Sniper having a rough old time. But then he turns things back around. Super comes in with a Chain Lightning and with a few more right clicks. Shrapnel. One charge left. And that will seal the fate of the Viper.
Yeah, and that's the risk of the Viper going enemy side against Shrapnel. It's always a risk. I mean, he was comfortably winning the lane just by last hitting and harassing, and takes it a bit too far. It just takes one rotation. I almost want to say that maybe they can make that kill without the Zeus because he had the third Shrapnel. I'm not sure.
It's always good to secure it though, and the fact that Super can now come and D-ward, take the top rune. If he doesn't miss every uphill attack, yeah, finally gets it down. They've known that ward was there for a while. But
yeah,
living it up.
Oh, top lane, Clockwork's in trouble.
Oh, he is indeed. Cogs are available, but what have we got left? He's going to be okay. One more orb attack will be needed. 5400 going for it. He'll die under the tower, but he gets the kill beforehand. Taken down by the Radiant Wisp.
Just barely worth it. He nearly didn't get that kill. Then almost looked like a suicide just for nothing.
Well, the Earthshaker is looking towards mid. Sniper, do you know he's here? Radiant Observer Ward up on the top rune spot. Yeah, they know. Signaled out now, they know the Earthshaker's there.
I think this career has just spent the whole game bringing Sniper tangos. This is like his third set of tangos now.
More tangos! How's the bot lane going? Slark at 19 for 5. He's lagging a little bit behind his counterpart up on top, the Tiny. Who has to go back to base now, though? Or does he? No. Nope, Wisp comes in with a bottle, meaning that the Tiny should never have to return. Never and go to Puck, the fountain again.
Puck's doing really well, actually. Puck's getting a lot of creeps, handling the lane very well. Part of it has to do with that early kill, but I think it's also, yeah, Puck's just playing this lane really well. Because you'd think that the AA, at least whenever he has Chilling Touch, can zone the Puck quite a lot.
He's got Orban Phase Shift. Turns to get some right clicks in there onto Virgo, just to try and deter him from going any further in, but Slark is nearly level 6. Actually buys himself a bottle. Oh man, Earthshaker. Earthshaker, where are you going? He's looking for the Fissure. He'll land it? No.
Earthshaker could die, yeah. Earthshaker's gonna die, I think. Maybe.
It's close. Magic Stick. Magic Stick keeps him alive.
And the fact that the Viper ran forward there, because I think otherwise Sniper chases with the Shrapnel, gets extra hits or two, gets maybe a second Shrapnel, and then ulties. Oh, he didn't have a second Shrapnel, okay.
Up at top, Clockwork caught in his own cogs, and he's going to fall this time for sure. Avalanche and Toss, he tries to turn and fight the Tiny, but then a little stone
time. At the same time, take a look, so Zeus just stole the top rune. So what do Tiny and Wisp do now? Tiny TP's base. And Puck finally goes down in that bot lane.
Yeah, he does indeed. Super heads towards mid, just harass down this Viper, I guess. But with Viper Strike and a few poison attacks, he could look to turn things back onto the Sniper, get a kill. And with Earthshaker still lurking around as well. Pretty easy opening.
Yeah, this Earthshaker, I'm not so sure. He's been walking around going for some kills, and he helped the Puck make a kill once, but other than that, his rotations have been quite ineffective, actually. Last one, we saw him actually being the one running away in the end. He's going to try and get some revenge on the Sniper now.
Yeah, he's coming in from an angle where they don't have any vision. Clockwork gets the cogs off before Avalanche and Toss, but looks like the Tiny still wants to get himself in there. Down a bot lane, AA, dropped low by the Puck as Clock is losing HP at a pretty rapid rate.
Looks like Pack and Earthshaker want to kill Ancient Apparition. And the AA knows that, so they're just hiding very deep. Because he'd die to Orb and a Fissure at this point.
Tiny going in, he's got Avalanche, he doesn't have Toss, and he misses one, so he can't get the other. Now the Tiny's turned back around, the Cogs will push him back, but finishing him off is not going to be easy. As he tosses the Clockwork into the Wisp, that's just going to secure a kill for him. Tether back, one more hit, one more anything. Rocket's coming off cooldown in 1 second's time, that should be an easy kill. Down onto the Wisp, and Tiny will get the counter onto the Clockwork.
Yeah, but this is what I was discussing. I mean, Tiny's made a kill in his lane twice in a row now. I feel like he sort of wants to go base again now. Or does he wait for Wisp to TP and give him a bottle? I don't know.
He's losing so much HP. He's playing super aggressively onto the Clockwork and losing out on all of his all his health and mana.
And when it's that mid lane, the Wisp always has bottle charges, refill, yeah. And you don't have to wait around so much.
Sniper. Caught out with a good Fissure here. Locked in, but hookshot into two. Cogs traps in the Earthshaker. That was pretty damn well played. Wanted to catch one instead of both, so he'd get the max battery salt damage down. As Viper is still walking in here. Lucky battery salts could seal his fate. But it looks like a few right clicks will finish off the little Clockwork. Double kill in the end for the Viper after killing off the Sniper and the Clock. And that's mech done. 9 minutes into the game.
Yeah, this game definitely starting a lot better for NewBee Miracle than the previous game, which at this stage in the game already felt like DK were...
Oh god, that's a DD puck! AA, wrong place, wrong time. Cold Snap gonna get jumped on here. He's still got phase shift though. If you can time this... Yeah, perfectly timed. He's got the orb to jump away. Super. Lightning Bolt level 3, but can't get into range. It looks like the puck should be perfectly fine just to jaunt away and get back to base.
Yeah, Cold Snap really playing this game pretty well. We didn't see the one time that he did die, but every time we've watched him, he's playing the pack quite flawlessly, I think.
I just want to point out that the Dire have a ground courier. Well, it's almost 10 minutes in, they do not have a flying courier.
Wow, that's... Is that... I mean, Earthshaker doesn't even have boots, so I guess he's been buying wards, and Wisp is Wisp, so they don't want him to buy... Flying Courier or anything like that.
So who buys it then? Who buys the Flying Courier? Is it Viper? He's got mech now? Just go and buy the freaking Flying Courier.
Maybe, I don't actually know. I mean, this Earthshaker is poor as all hell. I actually can't believe that. He's managed to get himself up to level 4. He has one death. He must have been buying all the wards, otherwise he would have definitely had boots by now.
Oh yeah. So often we see, you know, he's on 690, well, 700 net worth, let's call it. So often we see that, and it's because the support hero has, you know, Sol Ring or Brown Boots, and that's it. But he has neither. He's walking around with a couple of smokes, all of the support items, clarities to keep himself going. Clockwork is hiding in the trees, looking for a hookshot in, but who's he going to find? He's going to find the entirety of NewBee Miracle as they... Push up into this tier 1, hookshot across into a creep in fact, not catching anyone too much, but he does cog in the Tiny, and that's a great Ice Blast across too, mech not going to do a damn thing, and DK looking for more, Virgo does have Pounce available, they're not going to find any further kills, but they took down the Tiny Wisp, which is the most important.
How clutch was that Ice Blast? I mean, I wanted to say that this was a bad fight, and it was going to be turned around on DK because of the Viper's mech, but... Ice Blast really doing well there. Okay, Pax going for another kill here on Zeus.
Yeah, looks like he should get it. Super has no mana, no HP, and nothing really remaining as Cold Snap is now 1,000 gold away from his Blink Dagger with Phase Boots, Bottle, and Magic Stick, Magic Wand. Sniper, how are we looking for him? Not too great. Not too great at all. At this point, you know, Phase Boots, Ring of Aqua, it's okay. It's acceptable. You really would like to have that Morbid Mask or something along those lines, though.
Yeah, and I feel like Pack's getting closer and closer to Blink Dagger, and then Sniper's going to suddenly be a free kill. Zeus is going to be a free kill. That he's going to be hunting.
Well, Virgo on the spot lane. I saw the Gloves of Haste. I thought Midas would be his item. Slarks do suffer a little bit in the mid-game with keeping up their farm and item progression. But he's 2-0-1. If he does go for a Blink or a Shadow Blade or something like that, just to try and counter-initiate. And, you know, you mentioned it earlier in the draft. Setting up and scouting out, giving that recon and the intel that the DK need to get out Thundergod's Wrath, Assassinate, Ice Blast, all their long-range global artillery, pretty much.
Yeah, because it's all up now. Actually, I'm like really excited to see the first instance of Zeus ulti with Clockhook, with AA ulti, with Assassinate and Shrapnel. Because it's going to happen. I feel like it's a matter of time. all they need actually for that combo to work is A, he needs to throw the ult, he has clock hooks. Everyone else can just like do their stuff from wherever they are.
Tiny Wisp farming up the jungle. Phase boots and drums is a build I have not seen in a long, long time. Like, I don't think I've seen that since TO3 or something like that. It's always been treads drums from people like Era, or you go straight into the Ags. You know, you go treads Ags.
Yeah, this used to be the build, though, for a really long time.
Yeah, it used to be. And then, like, the maths was done. The fact that you get movement speed from Grow, with the drums, movement speed, and everything else, the Wisp giving you all of that, it means that phase boots don't really give you that much. You get max that move speed regardless, and especially if you're going into mana style later. But early on, the phase boots do give you a nice, you know, a nice chunk of damage.
I quite like tread switching as well on Tiny for extra stun tosses and stuff like that. Yeah. So it's another reason to try and get it. And there's a smoke here. I wonder, do they see the Wisp's little balls through the smoke?
I don't know.
If they have vision. I mean, they didn't have vision there anyway, but I feel like they might.
That's a good question, actually. Because, you know, if you cast a like Sonic Wave or Scream or something onto a Creep Wave while smoked, you see it, right?
Yeah.
You see the creeps die and you see the animation and things like that. I don't know. I'm going to say yes, but I'll probably get flamed.
Yeah, I want to say you wouldn't see like a Darkseer's Iron Shell or something, because that's like part of him. But the Wisps, those little, what are they called, spirits, they're actually like separate entities floating around them, even though they're connected to him. I think you would see them.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, here's the air ultimate.
Here we go. Everything thrown out. Viper, don't give a damn if you got level 3 in corrosive skin. I'll finish you off with an assassinate. Black Zed, though, caught in the cogs and will get taken out by the tower. Cold Snap TP'd himself in. Has the blink available, but look at how low they dropped. It was a 1-for-1 trade in the end. Hero for hero. But Puck and Earthshaker, they can't really do anything about this.
And if that kill attempts on any hero but Viper, then it's a free kill. It's only because it's Viper that the clock dies and trades is low.
Slark did go back for the Midas. So he wants to keep his farm going. He knows that with the magical damage and teamfight power that the rest of his team has, he's not necessarily needed right now at this moment in time to go around looking for kills and setting up for things. Maybe on the Wisp, though. He's been farming the dire jungle. There's nothing to tether to. 5,400 drops, and Slark gets himself another kill. 3-0-1. He bought the Midas like 2 minutes ago, and he's already got 2,000 gold.
Yeah, and Virgo's becoming the net worth leader, starting to gap everyone again like he did last game.
Out farming, out playing, and definitely showing his worth. Cold Snap, his blink, we've not seen anything really done with it. He picked it up, he didn't have it in the top fight, did he? He got it after, right?
No.
And then
he got it, and then he came mid to try help Viper.
Yeah. But we still are looking at Tiny building up into the Axe. He should have it by the 20-minute mark. He's got the point booster and 500-600 gold, 700 gold. So it's not too far away.
There's a smoke from Clockwork Zeus and AA to this top lane. And
it's not too far away until you get demolished like this. Ice Blast doesn't land, but the trail is still there. 5400 tries for the relocate save, but gets cancelled out with a stun. Good old Fisher from the Earthshaker will allow the Wisp to survive while back towards mid. Sniper actually in a 2-versus-1 scenario kills one. What?
Yeah, the Puck, I mean, so I was talking about how Puck can get free kills, but Puck himself is really squishy. So presumably what happened is they went onto the Sniper. It was fortunate timing that the Zeus ulti'd around then as well. And I think with the Zeus ulti damage, Sniper was like, I could maybe kill Puck before I die. I'm definitely gonna die, I'll just throw out some shrapnel, get some hits. Manages to get that trade, which is really good for Sniper in that situation.
Top lane. Earthshaker is ready for the Fisher. Cogs, though, really well placed to stop the Tiny from moving in, but he's not destroying one. He's now stuck by this tier 1 tower. He gets taken out by the Viper. So a decent takedown there, giving the Viper that killing spree.
Really, and Viper has also just picked up a late Midas, actually.
Oh, wow. I was kind of wondering where his items were. I was seeing the boots and the ogre belt and thinking, okay, he's not finished treads, he's not got anything else. What happened after this mech? He's not been doing badly. He's 5-2-0, but we see a lot of the time Yasha picked up after the mech. just to give you that the extra right click attack damage, you know, just to keep you going in these team fights. It doesn't fall off like the Aghanim's does too early on. But the Midas is even more down that route. You know the DK, they want to farm up and get themselves some big key items. Then they're going to start snowballing in teamfights. Slark now has a Shadow Blade. And his first usage of it is going to be to try and hunt down the Wisp again. He spots the Tiny, but that's not who he wants.
Oh, he got some global ults. Easy. He might go on him.
Oh, man. Rocket, pounce. Ice Blast is coming in. Yeah, just enough with a hook shot before it even lands. Now, 5,400
gold. Did they know that Wisp relocated like a few steps away? I wonder if they could have chased him, because he actually just relocated to like right there.
They know he's coming back. Pushed back by the cogs and... Oh! Rocket. Nice attempt by 5,400 to get himself out, but not good enough.
Yeah, and there's that global initiation here. Slark just running and saying, guys, everyone, focus your laser beams. And just managing to burst someone down with the help of all his global teammates. And that's, for me, I think this game's going to last quite long. And if it's not going to last long, it's only because DK keep getting these kind of pickoffs with their long-range initiations. It feels, though, the progression of the game feels like it's going to go quite late, and then you've got this Wisp Tiny that can split push all the time, so DK can't really close out the game. And on the other side, there's a Sniper and a bunch of like burst damage, so it's very hard to push against the Zeus and a Sniper and a Clockwork. But maybe the global initiation is what counts as the Wisp
like,
Tiny.
Like this again at mid. They got the Ice Blast, the Shrapnel to slow him down, and in comes Virgo with a pounce. Sniper wants this kill, and he'll definitely get it. Assassinate to finish off.
That's much better than if Clockwork's at the front, because we saw when Clockwork was at the front that Viper kill the Clock died. Whereas the Slark could always ulti there if he needed to.
Yeah, definitely. He has a regen rune bottled up as well.
Oh, Cold Snap. Cold Snap is... Gone very deep to try kill A, and really nice hook from Black Zed to catch him as he retreated. Finish off the kill. So yeah, things starting to look really good for DK at the moment, but... I wonder, if the game gets to the point where Tiny's got his Aghanims and Wisp and Tiny are just split pushing, does that global threat just keep them down, or do they just extend the game for really long because of the power of their combo?
I don't know. Sniper. Thundergod's Wrath is pretty big here, with the Slark jumping in. The takedown 2 before they can even get a counter kill. Tiny now, good avalanche, but it's not going to finish anyone off. Sniper dodges through it, dancing around, and that's a 3 for nothing as the Tiny goes down to the Slark.
Did Sniper get hit by that avalanche? Did he, like, walk through
it? No, he literally ran through it. Like, avalanche was aimed here. Sniper ran into the Tiny so he wouldn't get hit. It was perfect.
Yeah, that was pretty great. Wow. So... NewBee.M just getting pretty outplayed at the moment, and the Sniper TP in there, I think they would have seen it and been like, this is a Sniper, he's crazy, we're gonna fight him. But the constant global backup, I mean, Zeus and ALTs both have short cooldowns. Zeus is a little bit longer, but it's not long.
And this is Tiny now, 20 minutes in, struggling to get Aghanim's Scepter. While Virgo looks for... Orb has been used, they know he can't jump to anything, and Cold Snap is caught out in his own jungle. It's a tragedy. It is actually a tragedy right now for NewBee Miracle. They had a good start. They had a decent laning phase. But DK are
getting outclassed.
Yeah, exactly. Outmaneuvered, outplayed again by Virgo and DK.
Oh my goodness. Did you see the AA and Zeus both bought Midas is not as well?
I saw the AA, but I didn't see the Zeus. Wow. Wow.
They're just like, you know, Slark gets Midas, Viper's like, fine, I'll get one too. And then the enemy team's like, fine, well, our supports will just get Midas. Let's try one up that.
Yeah.
Because I don't think you're going to see an Earthshaker buy a Midas. That's not going to happen this game.
He's struggling to buy Sol Ring. Actually struggling. The Viper trying to build into what? A BKB now with an Ogre Club? But what does that do for you? Stops Thundergod's Wrath and Ice Blast. You can pop BKB to stop. Relocate in. Actually, good Dream Call onto 2. In comes a Tiny Wisp. We'll take down the Zeus with MS Toss, but Ice Blast down onto NewBee Miracle's Tiny. The fight continues with Virgo in the back, picking off one, picking off another. Who's his next target? Because AA falls to the toss. Hookshot back in. This fight is really disjointed, and it looks like it's going to be a 1-3. Black Zed looking for more. Rocket Flare, not enough. Cold Snap surviving and will be able to... No.
Kill with the Blade Mail.
No. Tries to jump himself out, but Clock Blade Mail, like you said. Illusory Orb sealing his own fate. Virgo heading down towards bot lane. They know Relocate's on cooldown, so they know that the Tiny and Wisp are stuck down here for a short while. They've got TP scrolls, but they want this tower. They want the gold bonus. And I'm pretty sure that Virgo could go in here in 1 versus 2. Hookshot off cooldown in 15 seconds. Okay. Okay. TP cancelled. Ice Blast. Yeah. Tiny, you're dead. You've got Aghanims in the stash, but that's still your demise.
NewBee.m took one good fight and then got a bit reckless with how much space it made for them. Needed to get out just that little bit sooner because there was nothing else to stop the TP except the Zeus bolt, so they just needed to get away before he could get there.
And now Super goes around looking for these Observer wards. Lightning Bolt, such a great tool. Zeus, one of, like, his main thing is vision. Thunder God's Wrath, you can scout out the enemy. Sure, it does damage, but you know when they're smoking up, you know when they're farming jungle, you know that, you know, when they're baiting. If you see one hero off on their own farming really high up in the lane, you can be thinking, okay, most likely they're baiting. We can't go for this kill. With Thunder God's Wrath, you can know for sure. And then with the Lightning Bolt, you go around taking Observer wards.
Yeah, and I'm basically just watching Slark. I mean, right now he's farming, but he's got a full Skadi. He's gapped people again like last game, and if you watch Slark and Clockwork, you basically know where the action's gonna be because the global stuff's gonna follow those two heroes. Looks like Slark is gonna catch someone here.
Oh yeah, they're spamping Insane as a hero up here, ready for the take-in. 5400 tethers back onto the Viper. Ice Blast is all pretty damn good with the hookshot in, gems on the floor, and Viper. Where's the pounce? Where's the jump? There we go. We've got it now onto the Viper. Throws down some attacks down onto Shizuri. Cold Snap. Dream Coil. Yep. Catches the AA and finishes him off, but he's dropping so low. One more hit from the sniper takes him down. Tiny is pretty much last man standing. With Earthshaker just behind him, we'll block out the Slark and stop the aggression, but...
Yeah, pack in that position, blinking in, then orbing forward, and after that, it was just like, there's no chance he's going to live. But Tiny does have his Aghanims and gonna start farming a little bit faster at this point. Heads over to the Ancients. I don't know, Wisp and Tiny is a combination that when the game goes to sort of the mid to late game, usually it dominates the game with a split push. But I do wonder, the amount of mobility and sort of global initiation from DK might counter that.
Oh boy.
It's quite difficult for the Wisp and Tiny to go off on their own.
Is he going in here? He's going in here. And why the hell not? With four hits and the pounce, he takes down the Wisp with ease. Toss up into the air, actually. Hookshot screwed up. Just missed. But came short. But Virgo is beyond godlike with a double kill of TPs. TPs coming in, but Black. Does he catch him? Does he get him? Nope, not quite. The jaunt away from the puck will allow him to get back to safety. But this Slark, holy shit.
Yeah, that answers my question really well. Can Wisp and Tiny start dominating this game by split pushing? Nope. Because if they go off on their own, that's going to happen to them.
They were farming their Ancients pretty happily, you know. Just walking around. Slark is trying to defeat backdoor protection, but not quite managing it.
Yeah, that's what happened to Wisp and Tiny when they were, like, behind their own lines, in between their Tier 1 and Tier 2. So imagine if they try and actually split push. I don't think they're going to feel comfortable doing that in this game. And Sniper's got pretty much a whole BKB, almost. He's missing one, just the hammer, I guess.
Yeah, he went back for the Mask of Madness a couple of minutes ago, just to give him that extra attack speed. He knows now that he's not in the position where he's going to get jumped on. It's the job of his team to do the actual initiating, because he went for the Sanjinyatra as his first item, skipped over the Mom. That was mainly because Puck had Blink, Viper is annoying as hell to deal with, and there's plenty of damage output from NewBee.Miracle, which they're going to try and put to work right now. As they walk towards the Roche pit, DK taking it slowly but surely, plinking away with their right-click attacks. Good Fisher in, here comes the Silence and Dream Call onto two. Clockwork and Slark both caught out, but there's no follow-through, and there's no real damage output as the hookshot goes back onto the puck and takes him down. Virgo now, one versus one against this Tiny, pretty much. The pounce! The toss screwed up the pounce, but they'll still finish him off, and this looks like it just might be. Game over for NewBee.Miracle.
Looked like he pounced backwards. Looked to me like he jumped backwards. That was pretty weird.
Yeah, it's a little bit odd. The toss seemed like it screwed it up a little bit. But back into the Roche pit they go. NewBee.Miracle lose 3 while DK looking strong, looking dominant. Earthshaker trying to steal the Roshan kill, but not going your way today.
I felt like because Newbee Miracle didn't have any vision there, their smoke broke and they were like, these guys are in rush, we need to urgently do something. And so they just have to like go into the fog, puck goes in. Looks alright to start with, but there's no real game plan. It's just like, it's now or never, we're just going.
Good Fisher, then the BKB from Viper. Doesn't mean too much when you're getting physically right-clicked down by the sniper in the slot. Maybe it saves you from Assassinate and Ice Blast, but that's a big hero to lose. That's your mech. That's your frontline hero, really, that you want to bait out all these spells that's dead for another minute. Oh, man. They found the clock. The relocate will take him back, so Tiny and Wisp not in any danger here.
Yeah, but if that's what their contribution amounts to, is occasionally killing one hero, it's just not going to be enough. Not even nearly. The Tiny and Wisp combo is meant to dominate the game.
Yeah, you're meant to set the tempo, you're meant to try and force the opponent back to defend towers, rather than being forced to defend your own, really. You're still looking at mid-tier one is standing. Tier 2 at top and middle, obviously, still up. While Cold Snap, he got a relatively early blink. He did pretty well in the laning phase. It's just mid-game decision-making and actual execution of their draft hasn't worked out at all.
Yeah, he's going to be feeling sad that he didn't go Midas as well. Because all these enemy supports and Midases are overtaking him in net worth.
Slark is diving tier 3, going 1 versus 4 right now. He does have Aegis Immortal, so he should be perfectly fine just to respawn up, but he's got no Shadow Dance. He's got no Get Out of Jail Free card. But when you're a Slark with Skadi, level 20, 29 minutes into the game, you don't fear the Reaper.
Yeah, the enemy team just like blew everything they had to kill you once, so you're pretty comfortable with respawning and just walking away. But yeah, it's going to be pretty soon that the Midas is on the air, and Zeus has already overtaken Puck, and it is getting there. And then this Puck, like you said, which had
it. Oh! Hook shot in! Black Zed with a perfect play! Ice Blast able to land! Tiny has no way out, is super! Turns back, he was the target, he was the bait, and it all set up perfectly. Hook, line, and sinker for DK as they draw Tiny Wisp in. But I've got to say, that hook shot was spectacularly timed.
Yeah, this clock's been playing out of his mind this game. I think I've seen him miss one hook the entire game. Hitting really well timed and well placed hooks, and even that little blade mail kill on Puck, I thought was really nice.
And the one hook shot he missed was like 50 range off. It wasn't missed because he, you know, had the angle wrong or he misaimed it or hit creeps or anything. It was just a tiny the range distance, yeah. So AC done up for the Slark now, gonna help them push up onto high ground, and that's a bloodstone for the support Zeus. That's a bloodstone.
And very soon, Aghanim's on the support AA. Needs 500 gold.
How do you deal with this? You've tried leaving the base as a Tiny Wisp, and not succeeded. Failed pretty miserably. Defending base, maybe it's a little bit easier. You've got Fisher to block them out. You've got Puck, Dream Coil to lock them in. Now you've got ways to split up team fights and choose your targets. But
so, what newbie M needs to do is they need to get a blink on the Earthshaker and then somehow hope it doesn't get disabled, even though there's like a million things to disable it. Because if they got a fight with the blink ES initiation, it would be great. It just seems super unlikely. Well, here they're gonna go with the smoke.
Oh, sniper has a BKB. Hookshot comes in onto his own teammate, but they'll find the three-man ice blast. No, they won't. No, they won't. newbie M actually backed themselves up, and Clockwork needs to try and bail on this as Slark comes in to clean up. They've baited their BKBs, they've made the spells get expended from newbie Miracle.
Yeah,
I don't know. GG is called. Yeah. It's kind of a foregone conclusion now as Hookshot, Aghanim's Clockwork just throwing them out. Doesn't really care too much. But that's DK taking a 2-0 sweep over newbie Miracle here in the VP game at group stages. Pretty convincing there. So newbie Miracle's third team, not off to a good start, but DK looking pretty good.
Yeah, DK looking really strong at the moment, and I want to find out exactly who is who for the next time we see these teams. I'm pretty sure Virgo is CTY though. I mean, it really looks like CTY as well, the way he's playing.
Yeah. Up next, guys, at 1 p.m., so in an hour and a half. I'm not sure if the game will start early. I'll let you guys know. I'll keep the stream running. In an hour and a half, technically it's scheduled for 1 PM CEST, is Newbee Young against Dream Gaming. So Newbee's second team up against Dream Gaming, which has Demons, Old Bird, and a couple of old faces on there. But that's going to be another two-game series here in the VP Game tournament. So we'll be back soon-ish, I guess. I'll let you guys know. I'll give you guys updates to see if it starts early, if we can get things rolling a little bit sooner. Because an hour and a half is a decent time to wait. So stay tuned. Grab yourself a coffee, a drink, something, some lunch even. It's getting to that time. Scant, thanks for joining me. You'll stick around, yeah, for the next series?
Yeah, I should still be here. Sweet. I'll let you know if something comes up. But yeah, I think I'll be here.
Well, we'll see you guys soon.